Hello, it's Maureen O'Connell from The Ray Foley Show, and I'm here at the Lighthouse Cinema for the premiere of Colin Farrell's new movie, which is called The Lobster. It won the jury prize at Cannes this year, and it's set in a near future, right? Where if you're single for more than 45 days and you're an adult, you get turned into an animal of your choosing. Yay, grimness all around for us singles. We're hoping to catch up with the star very shortly.
Hey, Maureen,
nice to meet you.
How's
it going?
Well, yourself?
I'm good. Now, in this film, being single is grim.
Yeah.
Do you think it's like that in real life?
I've been single a while. Has it been grim? I mean, it has its moments of absolute undiluted grimness, absolutely. But not as a rule, no. No, I don't think so.
And no one told anyone that they should have just gotten Tinder in this dystopian future,
seriously?
No?
Yeah. That'd be good. That'd be a much shorter film.
What made you want to take this role?
I just loved the script. I had seen Dogtooth, one of Yorgos's previous films. And I loved Dogtooth. I'd seen it about 2 years before I read the script, and then I read the script, and it was so particular and so unique, and I've never read anything like it. I'd never read anything that was so... that invented its own universe and its own set of kind of rules and conventions in such a particular way, and so beautifully and so seamlessly. And all the characters were so odd and bizarre, and yet there was something that was ultimately, it didn't feel like a pretentious trick, or it didn't feel like just something that was clever for the sake of being clever. It felt, how are you, Doyler? You all right, Eric? Good, pal. It felt like it was actually a very moving story about many things.
And you hit everything in this. Sci-fi, romance, comedy, drama. There's even a dog. Is this going to be the most all-encompassing film you've ever done?
I have no idea. I have no idea what that even means.
Yes, good point.
I have no idea. I don't know. I just hope people, you hope people respond to it in any way, shape or form.
Was it fun being home to make a movie?
Yeah, gorgeous. And it's worked out, like over the years, it's worked out every 2 or 3 years, yeah. I usually end up coming home. Not by design, whether it was Triage or then Ondine or then this, It seems to be every 2.5 or 3 years or so I end up back here making a film, which is ideal for me. So, and the West of Ireland is somewhere I'm really at home in.
And you hit Blanchardstown Shopping Centre as well, so that's
up,
always
we
nice.
Hit up Blanche, yeah.
Now today you came second in a poll of Dubliner's favourite Dublin actor to your In Bruges co-star Brendan Gleeson.
Yeah.
What are you going to do to knock him off his perch?
Oh, I don't know, man. I don't know. I want to start working out, doing some squats. Take some shunt to knock that man off his perch.
Can you grow a ginger beard? Is that it?
Got a ginger beard. He's the best, isn't he? Love him. I love him dearly, that man.
Someday it'll be you.
He's the best. He's the best of us, actually, as Irish. You know what I mean? Because he's bold and he's bright and he cares and he's soft, but he's tough and he's just... love him.
Listen, it's been a pleasure. The film was amazing.
Thanks
so much for chatting to us.
Thanks a million.
Cheers.
Dublin's 98 FM.